this morning. We are outside Fauna Primary School here in Bloemfontein. It's one of the fee-paying schools here in Bloem. All the learners have returned back to school today, and we found parents protesting from quite early this morning, from around 7 o'clock. They're demanding that the teacher be suspended and the Department of Education must launch an investigation. We've also understood that 14 teachers, those are SGB-appointed teachers, have been fired at the school. But to talk to us a bit further is one of the parents, Me Reni Oginze. Thank you very much for talking to us, ma'am. Just take us through the issues. Why are parents picketing outside the school today?
All right. First things first, we're having an issue here by the school about corruption. The school has a culture of corruption because the previous principal also exited the school because of corruption. And then the current principal, there is proof that the money that's supposed to be used for the school tuck shop is being used for personal use. We are also very concerned about the fact that all the grades are back at school, but 15 teachers have been laid off with no valid reason. And right now, this morning, we saw that a 14-seater taxi came in with 22 students sitting inside, and the front seat had two. Where is the social distancing? The culture of the school right now is to intimidate, because there's been some word that some of the teachers who were laid off were actually threatened. They were threatened. Their lives were threatened. And I mean, why would you threaten someone who speaks out about an issue from the school? And parents should stop being ignorant about what is happening at the school. You need to take action and do something about what is happening inside the school. These are not the only parents that are there. We are not the only parents that are there. Parents are dropping off their kids and they're going. We also noticed that while the kids were going inside the school, there was no sanitation. They were just walking in, and there's just no control measures. Right now, even some cleaners were fired, which means the school is not being fumigated. And one of the things that is important in COVID is hygiene. So who is cleaning the schools if everybody is not there, and the cleaners are not there? One of the buses that came this morning was being driven by the vice principal, which means there is a need for those teachers to come back to the school. And where is the money to pay those people? Where the money had gone to? There is no money to pay them. It's not ethical what is happening at Fauna right now.
We got to learn that apparently some of the parents were not paying their fees, hence, you know, the money issue that led to the school not being able to pay, you know, the teachers.
I believe every department, including the school, has got an emergency fund. You don't start planning your year in the middle of the year. The teachers were willing to take a pay cut. So now there's been a lawyer employed to fire these people, use the money that's supposed to pay them to employ the lawyer. So the parents paying for it, everyone was going through a financial difficulty. The teachers were willing to take a pay cut, and they were willing to come and work and say, okay, it's fine, we will work for this little amount, or we wait until you are ready. But they were just told, thank you for coming.
Let's talk about the school governing body. What is their role here?
The school governing body, there isn't a school governing body. Currently, there are 5 members, including the principal herself. The person and the rest were fired. So there is no, right now, there is no SGB.
Have the parents ever engaged the Department of Education?
We have engaged the Department of Education and ample times. No one has come to listen to our grievances. And currently, we are going to open a case of fraud against the principal. The problem is that we are facing someone who intimidates, so no one really wants to come out. But we have parents and we have teachers who are willing to come out. We do have written proof of what is actually happening in the school.
Thank you very much. That is one of the parents, Me Oginze, just talking to us. Teachers are very unhappy about the conditions at the school. I must mention that a few minutes ago, just before we went on air, police vehicles came through, about 2 police vehicles. I don't know if you were able to see one in the background, as well as a private security van. So the school seems quite concerned about the group of parents that's outside. But what I can also tell you is that earlier we managed to speak to one of the teachers here at the school, obviously wanting to remain anonymous, not wanting to be named, but that teacher actually confirmed to us that there's about 14 teachers that have been laid off at the school, and they are quite worried, those of them that are remaining at the school, about the workload, whether they'll be able to cope. As I said, the rest of the school has returned to school today. Literally, schools have reopened for the rest. It was only the grade 7s that had been coming. So it just goes to show that, there are concerns around the workload are quite valid. We'll be speaking to the Department of Education a little bit later. The acting MEC is out and about doing rounds to check how the reopening of schools in Bloemfontein, around Bloemfontein, is progressing. In the Free State, all in all, about 38,000, just over, in fact, 38,000 learners are expected back at school today. We'll be monitoring the situation throughout the day, but with that, it's back to you in studio.
Thanks a lot there from our colleague, Palesa Moet.